into some more fun, right? It's back. American Idol returns to ABC this Sunday, March 3rd. And Tampa Bay has so much talent that 5 contestants are on their journey to fight for the American Idol title.
I am so excited for this. And Shevonne Philidor is one of those contestants who joins us right here in the studio to share her audition experience, or what we can say so far.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Hey, thank you so much. Yeah.
So first, you auditioned in New York City. Mm-hmm. But tell us how many times you've actually auditioned for Idol. This is not a new process for you.
No. I've auditioned probably around like eight times, probably.
And you always do pretty well.
Yeah, no, I do. I do. I make it. I end up making it to the judges at least.
Okay.
Yeah. Not every single time, but I've done it 2 other times before this time. So.
Does it get easier each time you audition? Because you always hear on the show, they're like, oh, come back and see us next year. So it's great to hear someone like yourself who's done that. Does it get easier?
It definitely gets easier because every time you get that no or whatever, you know, you go home and you like kind of learn more about the process. You're like, maybe you just start to learn that instead of doing what you feel they want you to say or do, you start to just be like, I just need to be myself. And that comes with age and like time, you know. So
well, tell us about yourself. Tell us about what style of music, because you can't sing for us yet, so we have to wait for that a little bit. But tell us about your style and what you sing and kind of what your vibe is, because you definitely got the cool factor going on.
Yeah, no, I love to do like soul music.
Okay.
Some funk. I like to be fun. Reggae.
I'm assuming you write a lot of your own music?
Yes, I am a writer.
Okay.
I am a writer. And I actually did an original song.
I wonder
for the audition.
Okay,
that was
going to
be my next question.
Yeah.
So we can't say any more about that.
With that said, though, you've gotten to experience different judges too. You said you've gotten to make it to the judges, different ones. What are your thoughts on the different panels?
Well, the first time I made it to the judges, it was actually Nicki Minaj, Mariah Carey.
Oh, I remember that season,
Did you see them?
You know, I didn't see them fight, but they seemed to have some tension in
their
room. But, you know, Mariah Carey was really nice.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, I got to do, so I was in season 15, the farewell season.
Okay. Because you're going to come back, and we're going to talk more about your experience later. But why New York? I mean, tell about kind of that experience. Do you kind of make friends with the contestants?
New York seems like it'd be the largest.
Yeah, you know, it was kind of a last-minute decision.
Mm-hmm.
I've done the show so many times, and I'm, like, working on my own stuff right now. And I was like, man, I don't know if I want to do Idol again. But I was like, you know what? Fine, I'm going to go do it. It's my last time that I can do it. I'm 28 years old. Now it's the cutoff. So I was like, let me just try it one more time. So New York was like the only date I could go.
Okay.
And the closest.
And what I think's interesting, though, is you see people like yourself who's kind of making their career going to these shows because you have a different break. Where 20 years ago, before reality TV and music shows were a thing, you had to really do things in a different way. Have you been able to see how these reality shows have kind of affected the music scene when you do travel about?
For sure. The reality shows have affected so much, and not only the music scene, but just like the whole just music in general.
Mm-hmm.
And how you even make it today.
Yeah.
It's like you have to be some sort of like viral or something.
Well, do you have kind of story? I mean, because you feel like when you watch,
yes,
you know,
a story.
There's always some story. Do you feel like there's a pressure to put one out there?
I do. I mean, people want to get to know you.
Yeah.
The best part about all of this, the TV shows and stuff, it has kind of turned it back towards the artist.
Yeah.
And it's like, it's what you do with it. It's not what you do on the show, it's what you do after the show and vice versa. Like what you do, you can talk with your audience and really be able to make a connection that way. And all they want to do is get to know who you are. So the story is important.
Well, how can people follow you along this journey? As we are allowed to say more, you're going to come back. We're going to talk more about your actual experience auditioning. Do you recommend, can people follow you on social media and stay tuned that way?
People can check me out on Instagram, Shevizzle.
Okay, Shevizzle.
That's what they call me here on the show, too.
Shevizzle. You know, that's like the fun side. And on my Facebook. It's all the same stuff. And I also have music on iTunes and all that fun stuff.
Okay. Well, you're coming back for us. Seeing you again soon, okay?
Hey, yeah. Well, thank you guys so much.
And again, American Idol season premiere Sunday night. Be sure to check it out right here on WFTS.